What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we are back again. I'm with my friend Ankit from University of Magdeburg, and he recently made a video on electrical, right?
Yes.
Taking subjects with electrical engineering depending on the positions of benefics and malefics in the horoscope. And if you're new to the channel, then what you should do? Subscribe to it, right? See, right. Now he's also telling you must subscribe. And today he is going to speak on a beautiful instance from the Ramayana, the journey of Ram. Ram and Ayan means the journey of Lord Ram. That what is the meaning of the word Ramayana, which the great sage Valmiki Muni had noted after Lord Brahma instructed him to note it. He was a dacoit once upon a time. And then one day Narad Muni, the great sage, came and asked him that, for whom are you doing all this cheating? He said, I'm doing for my family, I'm doing for my father, my mother, and my wife and my children. So then Narad Muni said, can you just go and ask them one question, that are they ready to take part of your sins? And then he was very confident. And Valmiki's name was Valyarola that time. Then Valyarola, the great Don, went and asked to his family members that, whatever money I have for you, I do not have it by righteous means. It is through irreligion, through murder, and by wrong means. So, will you take a part of the sins which I have accumulated while giving these resources to you? Then all of them denied. They said, we will not take a part of your sins. We will not be the part of the wrong doings which you have done. You have to suffer it yourself. And then Valmiki or Valyarola, he was disgusted to hear it. He said, for you I am doing all this. You are not ready to take my sins. And then Valyarola became very frustrated. And then Narad Muni came, and then it's a long story, but ultimately he became the author of the Ramayana, which Lord Brahma instructed him that please write it, because he was very expert in Sanskrit and he was a great spiritually elevated rishi. And today Ankit from Magdeburg will share a beautiful story from the Ramayana and let us know what is the importance of contribution. And before beginning, as I say,
God is there with you.
God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will
be there. No, he will be there.
You will find him.
You will find him.
He's also learning, okay. Okay, so now we will hear from Ankit about the Ramayana. So I'll be looking to him and you also must look to him, okay. Don't look to me.
Okay, friends, you must have heard about the story of Ram Setu, how it was built. So once Hanumanji and all the Vanar Senas, they were putting the huge blocks of stones into the ocean, and they were writing the name of Ram, and because they were writing the name of Ram, the stones started floating in the ocean, so that they can reach the Lanka.
Yes.
So, in that story, actually, there was not one squirrel, actually, there might be many. So, that one squirrel was going to that Ram Setu. It was collecting the sands in its body. And when it reached to the Ram Setu, he was shaking his own body, and those sands were falling into the Ram Setu. So they were trying to contribute in their own way to serve Lord Ram, to serve the purpose of building the Ram Setu. So, but at that time, when Hanumanji saw this, he got concerned about the squirrel, and he told that this might be dangerous for you, as we are putting huge blocks of stones and you might get crushed in this. So because of this concern, he told that you can please move outside from this. But when Lord Ram saw this, so he told that no, he is contributing in its own way. Maybe the quantity is small, but he is also trying in its own maximum capacity to serve me. So whatever you are contributing, he is also contributing in the same way. I only see this in everyone, how they are contributing. I don't see in what amount you are contributing. I see only the intent in which you are contributing. So my friend will add to this, because he is the one who is expert.
Okay, so basically what's the lesson of the story? That contribution is more important than position.
Yeah.
Should we repeat? Contribution is more important than position. Because even in the Mahabharata, in the war of Kurukshetra, who are the two warriors on the side of the Pandavas who inflicted the maximum damage? It was Arjuna and Bhima, right? It was not Yudhishthir. Yudhishthir was the king, but he didn't do much damage. Arjuna and Bhima were neither the king nor were they the commander-in-chief, who is the Senapati. Senapati was Drishtadyumna, who was Draupadi's brother, son of Drupada. So, although Bhima and Arjuna didn't have any specific position as an authority within the war of Kurukshetra, but they were the ones who inflicted maximum damage. Arjuna wiped out the army just like a mad elephant, and Bhima was the one who killed all the 100 Kauravas, including Duryodhana and Dushasana, Vikarna. And Arjuna was the one who killed Karna, and he dismantled Bhishma also, and so many other countless warriors. So there you see, from the Ramayana, we get this lesson with this story, that although the squirrel was not able to do much contribution, as it could only put some drops of sand in the setu. And on the other hand, these big giant vanaras, like Hanumanji, like Angad, like Jambavan, etc., they were doing Herculean tasks. They were bringing blocks and they were writing the names of Ram, and they were just putting it so that it would float. And actually, Nal and Neel are the sons of Sugriva, and they were cursed by a sage that whatever you throw in water will not sink down, it will be floating, because they were very notorious in their childhood, like you and me were. So they used to throw the things from the rishis, from the sages, their personal belongings, they used to take and throw it in the rivers. So then one rishi, a sage, got very angry, and he cursed them, both of them, Nal and Neel, that whatever you throw will not sink, it will keep floating in the river or in the sea or in the ocean. And this acted as a very great blessing. So this is a very important lesson, that whatever position we have, when I say position, I do not mean any authority. We may be just another person. We may not be a very famous person. We may not be the topper of our batch. We may not be the most good-looking person out there. We may not be the most intelligent. We may not be the most popular. Or we may not be the most influential also. But we can do something. We may not do everything, but we can still do something. And that's what this squirrel says. And just see how Lord Ram behaves in this. Lord Ram doesn't say to the squirrel that, why are you only doing this much? So Lord Ram, instead of saying that, Lord Ram appreciates the fact that the squirrel is so small, even then he or she, I don't know, it was a male or a female squirrel. So I'm using the word he or she. So he or she had done this much at least. And now you can say, Hanumanji, he is a great personality. He has the power to bring that mountain also. What was the name of the mountain? Dronagiri Mountain, which he brought from the Himalayas when Arjuna was injured after being hit by Ravana's son Indrajit. Therefore, he can do anything, whatever he wants. But not necessarily the squirrel can do that much. I mean, there's no comparison of the quantity, right? But God doesn't see how much you give him. In fact, there's a saying I once heard, one guru was one day telling, God doesn't see how much you give him. Do you know what he sees? He sees how much you keep back. God doesn't see how much you give him. God sees how much you keep back with yourself. Let me give you an example to illustrate this. Suppose there is a beggar, a street beggar who earns only 10 rupees a day. Roughly 10 rupees he is earning every day. And then when he goes to the temple, he gives a donation of 1 rupee maybe. Okay. Every day suppose he donates 1 rupee. Then he is donating 10% of his money, because he is earning only 10 rupees and from there he is donating 1 rupee. Now, what if there is a billionaire? If a billionaire goes, and what is 1% of 1 billion?
Anyways. 1 crore. No. 10 crore.
10 crore, 1 crore, whatever it is. But what if he just goes and donates 10,000 rupees? So now, which is higher? The beggar is donating 1 rupee and he is donating 10,000. So now you may say that, oh, 10,000 is bigger, but how much is he holding back? There's no comparison. I mean, so God doesn't see how much you give him. God only sees the intent behind your giving, because many times we give bhoga to God, which means we offer food to God so that it is spiritually sanctified, which is known as prasad. And then many people ask us that, you offered the bhoga, the food, but when it comes out, it is the same. It doesn't get reduced. That means God has not eaten it. Or maybe God didn't like the food, or maybe salt was less. All these technicalities they will ask, the skeptics especially. But the answer is, God doesn't accept the food which you give. He accepts the purpose for which you give. That is to develop a reciprocal relationship with him, rather than just doing a business of give and take. And now, if you want to add anything, you can say.
No, I think you have added much.
Okay, he's a bit shy in the camera. Okay, do you want to share any other story from the Ramayana? Any other story?
No, I don't remember. I am not remembering anything.
He remembers actually, but he's not willing to tell. Anyways, so that is it from my side. And from his side also.
Yes, of course.
So if you want to talk with him, he has great spiritual knowledge. He may not look like that, like a yogi. He may have a speck, but he has his moon placed in the nakshatra of Pushya, which is the nakshatra of the great Bharat, who is the brother of Lord Ram actually. So Bharat Maharaj had his moon in the nakshatra of Pushya, which is considered to be the crest jewel of all the nakshatras in Vedic astrology. It is the best among all the 27, except Abhijit nakshatra, of course, which is the 20th, about which we will discuss some other time. So he has great spiritual wisdom. Again, I said, it may not look like that, but you can see he's wearing the specs so that you don't see that. And he knows so many pastimes from the Mahabharata, from the Ramayana, and the Srimad Bhagavatam also. And I'm very sure that next time, whenever I come to Magdeburg, or whenever he comes to Göttingen, where I am in Germany now, we will be sharing many more pastimes like this.
Of course.
And we will be trying to share the valuable insights which are there in the epics like the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. Alright, that is it from our side. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Thank you very much for your support and your story.
Thank you.
All right, until next time, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up. Tell them what to do. Click the thumbs up. You
should please subscribe to it and press the notification bell.
Yeah, so that you get emails when I upload.
Yeah, and also please comment to his channel what you liked about this video and his other videos.
And then,
and Jai Ram Jiki.
Jai Ram Jiki, Jai Siya Ram, Jai Shri Krishna. And what do you say in German? The bye.
Auf Wiedersehen.
No. How do you say bye bye? See you.
Tschüss.
Tschüss. Tschüss.